Okay, and now for our
next comedian, somebody that's apparently signed up. Here is Matt!
Because Matt rhymes with fat and Detar sounds a lot like retard. So fat retard was a large part of my childhood. It's gonna say okay, so boys in here, right? I am a coconut, for those of you guys who don't know. My mom is Mexican, my dad's white. So San Jose has coconuts? What? No. I have this Carly skin complexion that all stars want. And on the inside, I'm like super racist. I have friends who will crumple up pieces of paper and they'll shoot them and they'll be like, Kobe. Do you guys know who Kobe is? So they'll be like, Kobe. And I just wonder if any rapists are ever like, Kobe. fucking Roethlisberger, I don't care. Before I keep my dog, Before anything happens, I love animals, alright? I actually work with animals, alright? I have 600 volunteer wildlife, like I volunteered with animals for 600 hours. I can say some shit if I want to, alright? Too much literal shit I picked up. But I do, it's panned out, it's pretty good. I work at a zoo now, it's super, super cool. I love it. I got in trouble in my last set because I said the name of the zoo, so I can say that it rhymes with Happy Hollow. but it's cool, I really do love working at a zoo. At our zoo, we have a carousel there, and all the animals on it are native species. And the idea behind it is, you know, like try to show all these kids, like, hey, you should protect these animals, which seems like a great idea, except the thing was built like 30 years ago. So, like, almost all the animals are dead and gone already. It's literally the saddest merry-go-round in the world. We have water keys at our zoo, like they control the hoses and stuff, and we only have four of them in the entire zoo. They're like really hard to get. For some weird reason, I ended up with one at the end of the day, and I was like, man, this is probably the closest I'm ever gonna come to Mad Max. I was like, I control the water and the goats. We just got a new snake at our zoo. We got Kenyan sand boa. I love her. I love snakes. They're awesome. But she's like a short, chubby brown snake. I love her. She's adorable. But she's got eye problems. So snakes don't have eyelids. They have a scale that grows over their eyes. See, you guys are learning. But she wasn't losing her eye caps. I was talking to our vet, and she was like, yeah, she actually lose her eye. And I was like, whoa. I don't have the mental maturity to introduce people to short, chubby brown one-eyed snake and keep a straight face. Solomon, and he's awesome. Yeah, he's a cool parrot. He lives really close to my desk where I work, and I worked late in October last year, and I was the only one there. And it was October, so it was extra spooky already. And I was sitting there, and Solomon likes to do this thing when he's by himself, where he just goes, "Hello." Except Solomon is a parrot. So he knows how to say hello in 30 people's voices. He can sound like everybody. It's crazy. So I'm sitting in the corner shitting my pants, trying to figure out if that's a person or if it's just Solomon. I'm not allowed to talk to Solomon anymore, mainly because Solomon knows how to say hello, and God damn it, Solomon! You guys want to talk about fairies? I was an art major before I switched to biology, so I naturally have a bunch of furry friends. I was driving back from a show in San Francisco. That's right, I do shows in San Francisco, too. But I was driving back during the furry convention, and one of my friends called me. She's like, hey, what are you doing? And she pretty much invited me to the convention. Holy shit. shit. She takes me. Security here is awesome. For a convention center, I was like, no security. I am brought to the party floor of the San Jose Marriott, which is covered head to, like, the entire thing in plastic. So nothing gets spilled. I'm hoping that you're talking about alcohol. But every single room in this floor was giving away free alcohol. Just giving it to people. And naturally, I get totally smashed. And then she's like, hey, our friend is the DJ, we're gonna go over there. And I'm like, that sounds cool. So this culminates with me finding pictures of myself on stage at a furry rave, dancing with furries. I think I did cocaine that night, you guys. It was crazy. It was like a big furry blur that I don't remember. That was the point of that entire thing, is so I could say furry blur. I like to think of stretch marks as tally marks of sadness. I can say that because I have a few. I heard bagpipes the other week. Does anybody play bagpipes? Good! They're fucking horrible. I hate them. I don't like it. It sounds like a dying pig to me. But I guess that's why they play them at cops' funerals.
Like one person came, I love dinosaurs.
think dinosaurs are one of the coolest things that ever happened, and then God decided to piss all over it. They were really, really cool, and I've always been like a huge dinosaur nerd, and someone came over to me and was like, hey, do you know about dinosaurs? I was like, yeah, let's get this conversation.
You see Jurassic Park?
But they were like, what kind of dinosaur is a thesaurus? And I was like, are you stupid? Or a moron? Or idiotic? If you guys don't get that joke, that's fucking good joke, alright? If you don't know what a thesaurus is, buy a dictionary. I can't. Does anybody watch hockey? I love hockey. Yeah, sharks, right? Fuck yeah, sharks. I had a sharks joke, but can't fucking do anymore because they're winning. But let's just say they lose, okay? I just realized that San Jose sharks and actual sharks have a lot in common. You know why? Because real sharks don't have molars and they choke a lot. I like that joke. Do you guys know what YMCA stands for? Anybody? Young Men's Christian Association. Thank you. I like to think that the guy who made Gold's Gym was a Jew. Anything else? All right, yeah, this is one of my longer ones, so I'm sorry. It's heavy and it's a little bit dense, so hopefully you guys like it. I actually really love to read, and reading is one of my favorite things to do. I love Jack London. I fell in love with Jack London ever since I was a kid, and I read White Fang and Call of the Wild. If you guys didn't know, Jack London, in almost all of his books, talks about hands and how they're important, you know, tough hands make a man and things like that. And in Call of the Wild, there's a scene where a guy is up in a tree waiting to die from wolves, and he's looking at his hand, and he's amazed by it, how like the blood is flowing through it, the muscles and everything, and he's wondering how it's going to feel when the muscle is ripped away from his bone. I use mine to masturbate. So yeah, Jack. All right, guys, I think I'm going to wrap it up. My name is Fat Retard. Thank you very much.